letela sam 15 sati. Letela sam 15 sati od Pariza Air France-om do Čilea i bila sam u jednoj zemlji koja, kad bi trebala da kažem po čemu je poznata, rekla bi vam da je poznata po fantastičnim vinima koja su, počinju da potiskuju francuska vina. Upoznala sam vinogradare, upoznala sam ljude koji testiraju ta vina, videla sam vulkane i u vreme kad sam bila, javili su mi iz Beograda da je bio tamo zemljotres koji ja tamo nisam osetila. I onda sam iskoristila priliku da pitam ljude u Čileu kako oni gledaju na te stalne potrese i da pogledamo zajedno to. Hvala vam puno što ste došli.
Hvala vam.
Čileu ima 2800 vulkana, a od 2800 vulkana 55 je aktivno. Eno, onaj gore se puši. Ovde sam u mestu Pucón na 1000 km daleko od Santiago de Chilea. Ljudima koji žive u ovom gradu i koji su zapravo u samom podnožju vulkana, koji je naravno aktivan, to je potpuno nešto normalno. A za nas koji dolazimo i shvatamo da je taj vulkan aktivan, nekako se osjećamo nelagodno, a za njih je to potpuno svejedno i uopšte o tome ni ne razmišljaju. Jednostavno kažu, pogledajte ovaj pogled, a stvarno je čaroban.
We're used to that, you know. We're used to live with this nature. And besides volcano, we have earthquakes.
Yes, I know.
And we're very used to earthquakes, you know. For example, if we have a 6 degrees earthquake, nobody moves, you know. Nobody moves because we're used to that. Of course, if there's a strong earthquake, you will get scared. But with small shakings, we're used to that. So
you
it's normal.
You call small shakings the 6th earthquake. 6th grade?
Well, for our reality, it's small earthquake, yeah.
Sve su kuće napravljene od drveta. Tako da u slučaju zemljotresa one se samo kažu zaljuljaju, zaljuljaju se jedne na drugu stranu, ali se skoro ni jedna ne sruši. Tako da je sve ipak spremljeno tako da bude dosta bezbedno. Zato su kuće relativno niske i napravljene isključivo od drveta. Try to recall the last earthquake you survived.
The bigger one, the big one last year? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, well, that was more scary, I would say, you know. I remember being in my apartment, you know. The apartment was moving like a ship in the ocean. All the windows open, you know, all the things from the apartment fell down and crashed. So that was more scary, I would say.
I didn't really knew the magnitude of the earthquake, so I asked him, "Okay, father, are you going to go to work on Monday?" This was on a Saturday night to Sunday. And he told me, "Javier, nobody's going to work on Monday. Everything here is a mess. People are running on the streets. Everybody's stealing from supermarkets. They are trying to get anything what they want to survive."
When I arrived to Chile, it was maybe 2 earthquakes, and everybody even didn't mention it. And I was surprised because I got the news from Belgrade asking me how you are, what's going on, and here nobody even talked about it.
Well, we are quite used to having earthquakes, especially small ones. But, well, we have a history of them. And quite frankly, if it's not a big, big earthquake, we don't care that much.
It was a very bad experience for me. I live on the 21st floor, and well, it's very difficult to describe. So now I am feeling that again, and yeah, it was a very bad experience. So everything was shaking. My computer fell on the floor. And I didn't know if I continue living. I was with my husband in front of the bathroom, and we were hugging each other, and waiting for what could happen. It was terrible.
It was last year, is it?
Yes. Last year, February the 27th, about 3:30 in the morning.
Are the people afraid today that it could come back?
Yeah, everybody's afraid all the time because we live in Chile, and Chile is a country affected by earthquake frequently, so many people are afraid. Mainly people who live in the south of Chile, because they had their very big damages.
That was in Santiago. I was on the first floor, sleeping, of course, because it was, as she said, at 3:30 in the morning. But it's nothing you can do. You just have to wait until it's finished. So the only thing that I did was to stand up next to the bed. I grabbed the bed and then just wait for 2.5 minutes, and then it was over. But after this big earthquake, we also had lots of small movements or shakes, and till today.
But you cannot get used to it, no?
No, you can't. An expert said that probably we will still have those shakes for the next 3 or 4 years, maybe. It's possible. But, and we have, like, every 25 years a big earthquake. So last year, 25 years ago, and then 50 years ago also, so probably in 24 years now, in the future we'll have a big one again.